The highs and sighs of 2016. On Show Business Today, we have renowned filmmaker, critic and author Khalid Mohammed discussing the shocks and surprises of the year. Khalid, how nice to have you on Show Business.
Thank you.
As a cinema buff, are you really happy with the way 2016 has ended? I mean, it's ended on this triumphant note of Dangal.
Well, I'll try and answer it as straight, as accurately as possible. I think Dangal was a very good and very auspicious end to the year and a beginning of a new year. But when you look back, there have been, you know, even better films than that in terms of, let's say, just say entertainment, because I found Sultan to be more entertaining than Dangal. I like actors who can be surprising. Wow, how did he do that? Which Shah Rukh used to do in his earlier films.
Okay. If you had to compare the figures of Sultan and Dangal, they're going neck to neck, actually.
Trade figures.
Yeah, the trade figures. In fact, I'm going to just stop for a moment and give you some figures.
Okay.
Dangal, COP, 80 crore excluding Amir Khan's fee, recovery, domestic, 5-day collections, 75 crore, overseas collections, 64 crore. Satellite and other rights, 75 crore from Zee. Verdict, blockbuster. Sultan, COP, 90 crore excluding Salman Khan's fee. Total lifetime recovery, net, 350 crore. Verdict, blockbuster. Looking at these figures, Khalid?
I'm not a trade pundit, actually. Yeah. So whether it's the fourth day figure, the fifth day, or the first day, that doesn't really interest me. Of course, everyone wants a great initial opening, and that's what it's all about nowadays. But I look at a film qualitatively, and yes, Dangal was a four-star film. Sultan was maybe a little lesser because in terms of quality. But in terms of mass value and in terms of a good Bollywood entertainer, I would still say Sultan had an edge.
Do you think Dangal was as good as PK? Do you think it'll do better than PK?
PK, I didn't like, actually. I found that a bit...
Actually, I didn't either.
Okay, so we're on the same footing. But I think if you compare Lagan and if you compare, let's say, Dangal, you know, there are similarities and same attitude and same positivism, same nationalism, same fire.
It's been a good year for these two Khans, especially 2016, because Sultan and Dangal have done well. But what about our other Khan, Shah Rukh Khan? He had two releases, Fan and Dear Zindagi.
Fan, COP, 100 crore. Recovery, total from domestic and overseas, 74 crore. Satellite and other rights, 35 crore. Verdict, average. Dear Zindagi, COP, 35 to 40 crore. Recovery, total from domestic and overseas, 51 crore. Satellite and other rights, 40 crore. Verdict, money earner for producer, but below average for distributors.
Shah Rukh Khan hasn't had a very great year at the box office. But Sultan, Amir, Salman, they've had a good year.
Okay.
There's another person who's had an extremely good year, even better than the Khans, and that's Akshay Kumar.
Akshay has this ability or a gift to master him, you know, master whatever he's doing in terms of being convincing, whether it's a buffoon he plays in Houseful 3. I don't know how anyone can pull off that kind of silly comedy with the conviction that he does. Plus, he's been reinventing himself totally. You know, the Akshay Kumar of the early era and the Akshay Kumar of today are totally different. Of course, he has had to mature. If he hadn't matured, it would be a strange thing. But many actors don't. So Akshay, I think, has wised up, and maybe, I don't know how...
He needed to.
Yes, he needed to. And I think Twinkle Khanna, a.k.a. Mrs. Funny Bones and all, have had some impact on him.
I'm going to stop at this juncture and give some figures for Akshay Kumar's three films.
Airlift, COP, 60 crore. Recovery, domestic and overseas, 111 crore. Satellite and other rights, 40 crore. Verdict, super hit. Houseful 3, COP, 95 crore. Recovery, domestic and overseas, 112 crore. Satellite music and other rights, 40 crore. Verdict, hit. Rustam, COP, 75 crore. Recovery, 160 crore. Satellite and other rights, 25 crore. Verdict, hit. Out of these three films, which would you say was his best, Akshay's best?
So, Airlift was definitely way ahead. I think he needed to put a Parsi touch or a slight local touch to that character he played.
You had Neerja.
Yes.
You had Pink.
Yes.
And you had Dangal.
Yes.
So there were quite a few films that have done very well. And you've had a person like Sonam Kapoor, who's not really a saleable actress, but she was able to carry it off, and it is a commercial success.
It really moved me what she did, and her whole oneness with the character. And I'm sure she's researched it along the line. Absolutely. It couldn't have come straight out of, you know, thin air.
Then you're going to be very happy with the figures I'm going to quote to you just now.
Good.
Neerja, COP 25 crore. Recovery, 75 crore. Satellite and other rights, more than 15 crore. Verdict, hit. Alia Bhatt has had a good year. She had Kapoor and Sons, which was a hit. She's had Urta Punjab, which just about might recover its investment. And she's had Dear Zindagi, which has recovered its investment.
Right.
Kapoor and Sons, COP 37 crore. Lifetime, 73 crore. Verdict, hit. Urta Punjab, COP 40 crore. Recovery, 60 crore. Music and other rights, 8 crore. It's not a satellite-friendly film. Verdict, below average.
Alia's young, bubbly, petite, and she definitely has an understanding of the camera and how to emote and depend on a spontaneity. I think she also studied a character, Urta Punjab, very well. She wasn't recognizable as the prep, you know, the school preppy girl.
Yes.
Of Karan Johar, student of the year. She was far removed from that character, so it was a good change.
Khalid, sequels this year haven't fared too well in Hindi, isn't it? You've had a whole spate of them,
Houseful
except
three
for Houseful 3. You had a whole spate of them. I mean, you had Tum Bin 2, you had Force 2, you had Rock On 2, you had Kahani 2, Raaz Reboot. None of them did well.
Well, it just shows that some films shouldn't go in for sequels. Like, I think Rock On shouldn't have gone in for a sequel at all. And this Kahani 2 was not a sequel. It was a new film, new independent characters.
There was no
and,
need to call it Kahani.
So, it's just cashing in on a name.
I'm going to give you some figures for sequels
okay.
that didn't work and some that did work.
Kahani 2, COP 35 crore. Recovery, 18 crore. Satellite and other rights, 15 crore. Verdict, below average. Rock On 2, COP 45 crore, recovery 11 crore, verdict flop. Force 2, COP 45 crore, recovery 16 crore, satellite and other rights 20 crore, verdict average. Raaz Reboot, COP 30 crore, recovery 14.5 crore, verdict flop. Tum Bin 2, COP 15 crore, recovery, 2 crore. Verdict, super flop.
Okay, you're doing all the questioning, but we've been colleagues, right? So let me ask you a question instead.
Okay.
So what were you disappointed by in the year? I mean, what drove you nuts? What made you want to run out of the auditorium and tear your hair? Tell me two films.
Two films only? There were so many.
Okay, tell me.
There were a whole lot of sequels that I wanted to run out of.
Okay, name one.
Kahani 2.
Okay.
Raaz Reboot.
Mm-hmm.
These were the sequels. But there were films like Mohenjo-Daro. I expected so much simply because Ashutosh Gavarikar. And I've always thought that Hrithik Roshan is a discerning actor. Mm-hmm. So Hrithik Roshan, Ashutosh, they disappointed me.
Mohenjo-Daro, COP 140 crore. Recovery, 54 crore. Satellite and other rights, 50 crore. Verdict, flop.
I thought Mirzia was something I wanted to run out of. So there were a whole lot of films I would run out of.
What about Befikri?
Befikri, I wish I had never seen it.
Why?
I think it just took off on the wrong note. The first title song itself, where it just had a whole lot of people kissing, that itself put me off.
You're against kissing.
I'm against overdoing anything which becomes disgusting and not a pleasure to watch.
So it's disappointing, especially coming from Adi Chopra.
Befikri, COP 70 crore without including Aditya Chopra's fee as writer-director. Recovery, 47 crore. Satellite and other rights, 50 crore. Verdict, below average.
Aditya Chopra's film, which he has directed himself, there is a premium on that. When the boss himself has come down to direct the film, that makes a difference. Which were the films that you would think were the disappointments of 2016?
Well, pretty much of what we've discussed, the same films. I wouldn't say Mirzia was a... I wouldn't say be dismissive about Mirzia. It was a bit experimental and a bit art house, trying to combine time traveling in two different centuries or eras. And it got too airy-fairy. But I think, you know, The Boy has shown promise, and I think technically it looked...
I couldn't see The Boy at all. Under all that hair, I couldn't make out what the boy looked like. I would love to see a film where I can see Harshvardhan Kapoor and gauge for myself whether he can act or not act.
Mirzia, COP 50 crore. Recovery, less than 10 crore. Verdict, flop. Shivai, COP 135 crore. Recovery, 55 crore. Satellite and other rights, 45 to 50 crore. Verdict, below average.
I think Shivai has technical values which are very comparable with the international standards, and I think it looked tremendous, and I think it must have taken a lot of physical rigor for Ajay Devgan and his team to make a film, you know, that spectacular. But having said that, again, it suffered from the problem which many films do, including Dangal. It was too long.
Another big disappointment this year was A Flying Jatt.
A Flying Jatt, COP 60 crore, recovery 19 crore, satellite and other rights 20 crore, verdict flop.
Well, I think Tiger Shroff has a, you know, a charming screen presence. He's not over loud, he's not, over the top and all that. So one was feeling bad for him. The poor fellow was being not handled rightly. His hand movements were kind of odd in that. And I think as a reluctant superhero, he didn't quite come across. I mean, especially, you know, I think he has Baghi in the year also, which was, you know, invincible character in here.
But Baghi did very well.
Exactly. Yeah.
Commercially, it's a huge hit. Yes. And in fact, let me stop here and give you figures.
Baghi, COP 37 crore. Producer's profit 13 crore. Distributor's profit 19 crore. Verdict, hit.
And what would you say about 2016 finally?
You know, it's going to be tough to bring the audience to the big auditorium. Right. So I think somewhere they have to wake up and smell the latte.
After a mixed bag that we've seen in 2016, we're on to 2017. I'm sure we're going to have another mixed bag out there. Happy New Year to you until then.
Happy New Year.